I spent every spare moment for 6 months building a CNC milling machine. And now it's alive. And it's hungry. We're about to find out if it was all worth it. But first, there was some assembly required. Now, you might be thinking, isn't that thing gonna ring like a bell? And of course you'd be right. But I've got a little trick up my sleeve. By mixing some old oil with sand and packing the machine full of it, we can massively increase the damping. It also adds weight, which is never a bad thing with machine tools.
That's good having the one on hold, but an orientation.
Yeah.
Listen to that. Have you ever witnessed such a damp ring? Next was the Y axis. After aligning the rails, I moved on to the ball screw, shimming the mounting blocks to get the screw absolutely parallel to the linear guides. The XY plate also got a couple of shims. And I made sure the bearing reference surfaces on top were square to the Y axis before bolting it down. It took a couple of tries.
God damn it!
Did it the wrong way around.
I added a brass nipple and a hose to the ball nut so I can grease it without having to pull the machine apart. After going through all that again for the table, I now had the perfect reference plane to align the column. I got some help from my hunk of a housemate to lift the column into position. An engine hoist would have been the perfect tool here, but I'd already spent the whole budget on psychiatric evaluations, based around my tendency to obsessively pursue projects. We screwed some plywood to the wall to act as a ramp, and then used a scissor jack to lift the column just enough to allow the mating surfaces to be generously coated with high-strength epoxy.
Hello!
After lowering the column into its final resting place, I fiddled with the jack screws until it was as close to perfect as I could get it. Mounting the Z-axis plate went smoothly, with the help of some shims, of course. Hey, don't look at me like that. I installed the motors and their mounts, along with a set of I can't wait for the postman belts, cut to size and held together with fiberglass reinforced tape. You know how a counterweight works. We installed that next. And then in went the spindle. And then out came that spindle, and in went this one. Remember, bigger equals better. And that 1.5 kilowatt spindle was not cutting the mustard. If you blinked, you probably missed it, but I installed all the electronics in the cabinet, hooked it up to the machine, and it was off to the races. Alright, I guess I'd better give an explanation as to what's going on here. Basically, the power comes in here, runs up to this switch here, then goes back down and, does anybody actually know how any of this stuff works? And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. It's time to make some chips.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Ah, the perfect chip. You just can't get that with hand tools. All right, that's enough kidding around. The rest of the video is going to be completely serious. I'm going to run some test cuts in aluminium to figure out what this thing is capable of. It's looking good so far. Have a look at those chips. Perfect. Now that we have a good idea of an optimal cut, and a really good idea of a not so optimal cut, let's put that knowledge into practice. This time I'll cut a square, a circle, and a hexagon into the end of some bar stock to hopefully demonstrate the dimensional accuracy of the machine. And I'll pop a hole in the end while we're at it. Because why not? Isn't she a beauty? I reckon the subpar surface finish is a combination of forgetting to slow down the finishing passes and the small amount of backlash in the budget ball screws. But hey, all the features are within 0.03 millimeters of their target dimension, especially this one. And this one. Oh, and that one too. Which is good enough for the lady I go out with. Well, wasn't that exciting? Of course it was. Am I happy with how the machine turned out? Of course I am. But, as with any design project, there might be a few small changes to my approach the next time around. For example, I might spend a little bit more time just buying a machine from an existing manufacturer. There are definitely some things that can be improved here, and first on the list is a new spindle. As you saw, the high-speed spindle does really well in soft materials like aluminium, but when it comes to steel, it doesn't stand a chance. And frankly, the cutting noise of a 6mm end mill spinning at 24,000 RPM is uncivilized. Just ask my neighbours. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you've got any ideas on what I should make on this thing, let me know in the comments. If you haven't seen the build video, it's right here. And if you subscribe, I'll know you want to see more.